Now our next speaker is Marte Dirks. He is the General Manager of the Environment Research Center at Daikin Europe. And we all know we need a real transition of research approaches into strong collaborations with industry. And Martin Dirks knows very well what industry needs and what industry already does to contribute to the energy transition. We've seen Daikin growing from a component manufacturer to a global player in building comfort supply in a multi-energy vector context. Martin, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Lieve. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I will not introduce myself with my name again, but today I will explain some thoughts as a leading manufacturer in the heating, ventilation, air conditioning and refrigeration industry. This I will do by five subjects. Just a moment. Yep. Our company direction for sustainability as an example, the company environment vision 2050 as an example, then some carbon neutral solution through innovation and cooperation that is needed for it, and initiatives on circular economy, and some thoughts about relevant European policies and sustainability aspects for our industry. In view of sustainability, we are aiming for a net zero carbon emission while providing a safe and healthy airspace. This is based on three pillars. No growth of the company without contribution to the environmental protection. This is essential to create a sustainable growth of the company. Short-term results may be impacted by it, but on the long term, it definitely will show the payback. Developing and popularizing environment-sensitive air conditioners as a key to sustainability of the company. As on a global level, the cooling demand is expected to grow drastically. And the net zero environmental vision with product solutions and the power of air towards 2050. In May 2018, we published our company environment vision 2050. This environment vision will be realized through product innovation, solution creation, and through the power of air. Cooperation with several stakeholders via an open innovation platform, including the Internet of Things and artificial intelligence, will lead us towards a safe and healthy environment. Our Vision 2050 path towards a net zero emission will always take into account the needs for the society, such as safeguarding against heat strokes, better creating a better work condition, and assuring a better sleep environment. It is important to note that the carbon neutral target includes the carbon during the life cycle of the product, the operation at the end user. This is reflected by scope 3 emission reporting of the Greenhouse Gas Protocol. The power of air is a key message of the company. It is our will to contribute by a safe and healthy air. Due to the needs and technologies, the values are classified in three categories: safe and secure air, healthy comfort, and bountiful. 3 years after we published this vision, the importance of safe, secure air is a top priority more than ever. In the future, also the other aspects will be more and more important. You may have recognized that many standards and regulations are under preparation now. Sometimes they are popping up like mushrooms. But a unified approach focusing on result prescriptive regulations and standards will be most important to accelerate innovations in this area. In this picture, you also see an application of safe air in a historical building, the Belfry of Bruges. How can we achieve a net zero carbon emission goal based on the Scope 3 reporting? For Europe, it looks easy because they will make carbon neutral electricity, but we are not only supplying products to Europe. More efficient products and the use of lower GWP refrigerants will be a large part of this achievement, together with the decarbonization of the heating sector. This heating sector can be decarbonized by use of heat pumps. We will also enhance our offer towards energy service solutions. As you know, buildings play an important role in the energy consumption and related carbon emissions. The collaboration with stakeholders to come to low energy buildings while making optimal use of renewable energy shall result in a large reduction of the carbon emission. Use of low GWP refrigerants can create also the reduction in a large stage. Here also, the recovery, recycle, and reclaim of refrigerants play an important role. Furthermore, offsets such as forest conservation will be required to realize the net zero emission target. To achieve carbon neutral solution, the harvesting environment for innovation should be optimal. To create this optimal harvesting environment, first of all, we need to work towards the target. We should move from energy performance to carbon performance of buildings. Of course, not forgetting energy efficiency. This clearly including the carbon performance over the lifetime. And here, certified simulation tools should create a more open platform as inhibitor for innovation. These simulations should include the interaction between the time-based carbon intensity of the power supply and the building energy needs, as well as the benefit of energy storage, including cold and heat storage. Besides the working to the target, we should make sure that innovation gets a quick return on investment. In the building sector, regulations are an important key. Innovation should be flexible, included based on a result prescriptive requirement. Even still today, sometimes it takes more than 10 years to get high contributing innovation reflecting in the building performance regulations, as some of these regulations are very technical prescriptive. As a larger market will create bigger results, a unified methodology over a wide territory is essential. To achieve this, it is clear that national interests should make place for a European unified approach and the benefit of the climate targets. Finally, the value of carbon should be better reflected in the building operation cost, so that innovations are faster implemented, even if the regulation does not have such a specific requirement. The main challenge is to provide data about the future carbon intensity of energy for the different regions. Actual data is clearly available. The HVAC industry become an important partner in the route towards a carbon neutral building. As the building shell has drastically improved, the technical installation becomes more and more important in the contribution towards a carbon neutral result. The manufacturers of these technical installations have the task to contribute to the improvement by providing better data so that more reliable simulations can be achieved. As manufacturer, we take several initiatives to support and act for the European and global standards preparation, including proper data for dynamic simulation methods. This in cooperation with the present building energy performance stakeholders and its experts. In Europe and on ISO level, a dynamic simulation standard is under preparation. For the moment, this is hourly based, as it is considered to be enough for the time being. To have a proper simulation, a full range of data of equipment at all temperatures conditions and load conditions is required. We developed the methodology to prepare a map of data, starting from the so-called eco-design regulations, as these data are under market surveillance by the authorities. These standards are now in a stage ready to go for comments. Today, the standards show energy-based results. The next step is to become a carbon-based standard. Here also, to include smart systems, we may need to move from an hourly base to quarter, 5 minutes, or even shorter base simulations. This dynamic simulation can, of course, include interaction with the power supply network as well as all forms of energy storage. Besides energy use and carbon emission, resource efficiency will be a big challenge in the coming decennia in order to assure a sustainable business. As a refrigerant has also an important impact to the carbon, we take this as a priority. As manufacturers of equipment, we use all kinds of refrigerants, synthetic, non-synthetic, but considering here the balance of the important aspects of the refrigerant choice during the total life cycle of the product, and important, aiming to assure accessibility for all regions in the world. Proper installation, proper use and maintenance contribute to the reduction of CO2 emissions due to refrigerant leakage, both from the refrigerant itself, but also due to energy consumption increase when the refrigerant is lacking. As such, to prevent emissions of refrigerant and to assure the proper treatment of refrigerant and end of life of the product, we have to collaborate with other stakeholders that are part of the life cycle of the product. As you may know, we are acting already for the circularity of refrigerant during the different stages of the product. In Frankfurt, we have specific plans for reclaiming, distillation, but also for converting refrigerants into suitable substance for other applications. Clearly looking to circularity. As a manufacturer of equipment, we established some years ago the LOOP program, where we used reclaimed refrigerant directly in our production of new equipment. And in March and May this year, we organized expert meeting on circular use of refrigerant with relevant organizations. In these meetings, participants share the necessity, capability, and potential of the circularity of refrigerants. In cooperation with the WEEE Forum, that's Waste of Electric and Electronic Equipment Forum, we agreed to link the cross-industrial stakeholders to generate an optimal circular economy. We start with refrigerants, but we will end up with total equipments, and who knows, even more for the solution parts of the building. In Europe, there are several initiatives to steer the society and industry with a strong focus on sustainability, the Green Deal, including circular economy, decarbonization, the Sustainable Product Initiatives, the Enhanced Producer Responsibility, are just some examples of this. For the industry, it is most important to have a unified approach in Europe. We should remove all barriers on our path towards a European-wide circular economy. This is the only way to become the leader on a global level. With the European approach, we can become an example for other regions in the world, but we have still a way to go to realize this unified circular economy and an open European market. As industry, we take initiatives to create the unified approach in order to create an excellent atmosphere for a competitive market that is open for innovation. We all face the same challenges, and working together is essential to realize the target of a sustainable net zero emission society by 2050. With this, I conclude my thoughts and wish you all a fruitful and safe conference. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much, Martin, for a very broad vision of a multinational and really looking at all aspects that, of course, will guide you in your strategies and also showing to policymakers that really the regulatory frame has a huge impact on what speed we can attain in this transition.